there's going to be a shootout. Wildcat style. Sit a spell and enjoy. Showdown in San Antonio.
It's Final Four Eve, deep in the heart of Texas, and a Kentucky team without a lone star is going to try to win its seventh national championship. We are so happy to be with you here from San Antonio. We're on the Riverwalk with a lot of the UK fans who come out on this Final Four Eve to get things going. Ryan was at the open practice this afternoon, got a chance to watch the team. How do you think they look? Were they tight, loose, what?
Well, a matter of fact, we talked about it during the sports cast. Stanford came out very loose. Kentucky very much businesslike. They kept it businesslike. Not a lot of smiles on the Kentucky part, so you can analyze that how you want. Could be good or bad. I got to tell you, though, I went over to the Alamo Dome just a minute ago to pick up some videotapes, and it was Jamal McGlure buying a hot dog at one of the local hot dog stands right up here on the Riverwalk, just out walking around. Saw Ryan Hogan walking around out here with his parents, so a lot of fun here as we get ready on the Final Four Eve.
I think that's a really good sign.
Yeah, I think it is a good sign.
Well, Tracy, we've been here for a few days, so we're really getting to know the fans.
Pretty much, I'd say so. It is a family atmosphere, at least tonight. And you know, folks in Texas do everything big, and that of course includes a big welcome. Just take a look around town and you'll see a welcome mat laid out for the Cats. Here's what it looks like all over the place. We've got stickers and signs and banners all over the boats, which one's right through San Antonio, of course, where we're hoping to sink Stanford. We've got also flowers. Of course, our state flower here is blue, just in time for Kentucky. We love that. But you know, while the city seems prepared, were they prepared for our fans? You may not like the perception of True Blue fans.
Well, you know, so far I haven't had a chance to form an opinion. We keep waiting for these big Kentucky whiskey drinkers to get down here, these good old boys, and so far it's been pretty mellow.
That could change.
Yeah, we're waiting.
Right now we want to go out to Nancy Cox and Stuart Shepard, who are in Fayette Mall with all the True Blue fans who stayed at home, and they are cheering just as loudly, aren't they?
Oh, wow, Robyn. I tell you, if you can't be in San Antonio this weekend, this is the place to be. We've got thousands of True Blue fans out here. Wow.
Terrific crowd tonight. We're down here handing out, of course, True Blue fan buttons and also letting people register for some giveaways we've got. We've got some great helpers here as well. We've got the Henry Clay High School Pep Band here and also the cheerleaders from Henry Clay, from Paul Lawrence Dunbar to the Woodford County Middle School. Just cheer on.
Thousands of a big win this weekend. We're ready for number seven. National title number seven.
Most of the people I've talked to tonight have shared the same feelings that we've shared, and that is that the fans cannot wait for 5:42 tomorrow night when the ball finally tips off.
But we're going to have a little party right here as we Robyn, let's hear from the band.
Here. Well, this really just has been an absolutely incredible year, hasn't it, Ryan?
Right. You know, with Kentucky playing so well in the postseason, it's easy to forget how far they've come from day one when Tubby Smith was named new coach. You know, the season began with a lot of new faces and just as many question marks. Tom Kenny now recaps a season to remember.
This has been a season of change. A new head coach in Tubby Smith and six new players who didn't even play college basketball last year. But one thing that hasn't changed is the winning. The season began in November when an old friend came back to Rupp Arena as a new foe as UK beat Kyle Macy's first Moorhead State team. Then it was off to Maui and a rematch of last year's national championship game. And unfortunately, the outcome was the same. The Cats lost to then number one ranked Arizona and settled for third place. But then UK ripped off eight straight wins, including this one over rival Indiana, which was highlighted by this gravity-defying dunk by Jeff Shepard.
Wow, he took off on the baseline!
But then came perhaps the low point of the season, this home loss to in-state rival Louisville. The dream game was a nightmare for UK. There were also unheard-of home losses to Florida and Ole Miss, which had some fans wondering what was wrong with the Cats. But hope and dedication allowed this team to overcome adversity. After Nazi Muhammad moved into the starting lineup, UK won 9 straight, including this improbable buzzer beater by Muhammad at Vanderbilt. And there were other the first Smith family reunion at Georgia, where Tubby coached against his son Gigi, who played against his little brother Saul, where Tubby used to be the head coach. And there was the always emotional senior day honoring Cameron Mills, Alan Edwards, and Jeff Shepard. That was followed by the school's 39th regular season SEC championship. And remember, the Cats weren't even picked to win their division this year. But then came the postseason and an outpouring of the unexpected. The Cats didn't just win the SEC tournament, they owned it, routing teams by 20 and 30 points and earning the program's 21st SEC tournament title. Heroes welcome home at the airport. That dominance continued into the NCAA tournament, which the Cats turned into their playground, demolishing every opponent and steamrolling into the South Regional title game against nemesis Duke. In this game, the Cats changed the way we define impossible. After trailing by 17 points with less than 10 minutes to play, Kentucky made a courageous comeback that not only put this team in the Final Four, but also in the latest chapter of Kentucky basketball lore.
Obviously, nobody playing better basketball in the country right now than the Kentucky Wildcats.
I'll second that. Look at what some of the fans are drinking. This is how they're doing the drinks down here on the Riverwalk. Well, don't smell. It's not like we're not drinking it, but they've got these huggers, and then they've also got the basketball on top. And, you know, that's just the way it is around here. Nothing but basketball, huh, Tracy?
That's right. True Blue fans, you know, we're expecting our win. And we've got some huge voices. Does that make you guys feel sorry for Stanford with quiet little voices? Are you at all worried about those poor little Stanford fans? What are they going to do? What are they going to do to pump up the volume against our surround sound, True Blue fans?
You know, Kentucky fans are loud. I don't know how you guys are going to compete. I hope you've got a game plan.
You know, Stanford is known for its spirit, and you're going to hear it in Kentucky.
Well, I have a pretty high voice. I'll scream as loud as I can.
Yeah, we got some megaphones we're going to bring in and some strategically placed microphones, and we'll get it worked out.
There's 100 Stanford fans. Do you understand that we've got like a million?
Being in the Final Four is a surprise for us. Within the last 2 weeks, we've rallied our troops, got a ton of people out here, done house, you know, type deals. And you know,
it's been a whole community effort.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You have a great team. We have a great team. We are so excited.
And I just want to add that Dean Montoya let everyone into Stanford, so he's really responsible for us being in the Final Four.
I know that brains and basketball go together, and we're going to show that.
We will be right back with much more live in the showdown from San Antonio.
We feel like we're a team that like to get the ball up and down the court. We feel like we have a pretty good transition game, and if we can get easy baskets in transition, we do, but we're very versatile.
There's performance and safety. There's Ford Taurus. There's sophisticated styling and comfort. There's Ford Taurus. There's a $249 lease available for 36 months. There's Ford Taurus. There's only one place to get it, your local Ford dealer. There's real driving enjoyment. There's Ford Taurus. There's practicality and affordability. There's Ford Taurus. There's low 1.9% financing that can save you big on your monthly payments. There's only one place to get it, your local Ford dealer.
Do you know how many grams of fat are in that bag?
Nope.
Would you guess 53? Let's take a look, see what you got under the hood there. Brown stuff, orange stuff, meat. Something dry and something wet.
Don't eat food you're unfamiliar with.
Have you taken the Subway challenge?
Subway has 7 great tasting fresh value meals with 8 grams of fat or less. No wonder millions have taken the Subway challenge. Subway, the way a sandwich should be.
That special sauce, do you feel special? I do.
Your injuries are much more
this
serious.
This injury will require extensive
no!
therapy.
No! Workman's comp does not
I'm sorry, but once you use up those sick days, they're gone.
What are we going to do?
If you or a loved one has been injured in an accident or has become disabled, you need an experienced attorney for maximum possible results. Call me, Shirley Cunningham. I've worked hard all my life to beat the odds, and I can help you do the same.
Get some peace of mind, get Shirley Cunningham on your side.
The next few moments are brought to you with pleasure from Gatlinburg in the Great Smoky Mountains of Tennessee. Gatlinburg offers you the best of any world, anytime. Get away from it all. Get away to it all. Because whatever you're looking for, you'll find it in Gatlinburg, Tennessee, the home of the Great Smoky Mountains. Call 1-800-267-7088.
Hybrid Springs Bottled Water for office and home delivery. Springs Big Blue Swish. It's all over town.
Hi, everybody in Lexington and Northern Kentucky. Don't have tickets, but we're trying our best to get them.
Keep your fingers crossed for us.
Welcome back live to San Antonio. Cat fans are getting rowdy on this eve of the Final Four. And you know what I heard when the Cats got in yesterday morning? I heard they were walking through the lobby of their hotel, and Tubby actually looked a little bit nervous.
Well, matter of fact, he admitted that today. The Cats got on the plane for today at the Alamo Dome, went through a practice, and not only are the players probably a little nervous, but Tubby admitted today that he'll probably be more nervous tomorrow, and it kind of makes us wonder, you know, whatever happened to that Rick Pitino fella?
Regardless of what happens in the Final Four, Tubby Smith has had a great year in his first year as the head coach of the Kentucky Wildcats.
These kids have really, I think, overachieved and played beyond a lot of expectations. So we feel very comfortable with the achievements so far, but we know that we still realize that there are other goals that we want to achieve as well.
You know, we had some good moments and some bad moments as far as winning and losing games, but through it all, we continued to grow together as a team and stick together as a team, and that's what's been special about this season, how we've grown as a team no matter what happens, and that pretty much sums up our whole season.
Smith is in an unusual situation this weekend because his players have more Final Four experience than he does. For most of the Cats, this will be their third straight Final Four. For Tubby, this is his first.
Well, I'm sure I'll be pretty nervous come tomorrow, but as we prepare, you know, we've watched the Final Four and attended the Final Four as a coach going to clinics.
Tubby also hopes to add another first this weekend, his first national championship, and first up, the Stanford Cardinal.
In our league, I would say Ole Miss is very similar in their ability to, they're pretty physical. Not that they're, I think Stanford's physicalness is in their size, I think, and they're pretty aggressive inside play. Whereas some teams are more aggressive on the perimeter, and where they're overplaying, denying, and bumping your cutters a lot.
Well, from Kentucky present to Kentucky past, in one word, Coach Adolph Rupp. If he were alive today, he'd be 97 years old, and I had a chance to talk to his 57-year-old son, Herky, last night. You know, there's a group in Lexington who makes sure that every Final Four, Adolph Rupp is never forgotten.
A copy of this is the Basketball Hall of Fame in Springfield.
It arrived Thursday in San Antonio, the Adolph R. Rupp Trophy, worth its weight in athletic honor.
It's dusty and dirty.
It's made primarily of copper and weighs 111 pounds.
This trophy actually belongs to the Commonwealth Club of Kentucky, Inc., which in 1972 set out to honor Coach Rupp. You may recall that's the year that he retired as basketball coach from the University of Kentucky after 44 years of service to our community.
Jerry Calvert played for Coach Rupp and heads up the Commonwealth Club, a group of Kentucky business people and former players who each year honors the Associated Press Player of the Year and Coach of the Year at the NCAA Finals.
When Coach Rupp brought basketball to the state, he made an adhesion that all the people could come to. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't just at the University of Kentucky, it was the other universities, mm-hmm. because they set out to try to beat him.
So So the trophy is the club's way of immortalizing Coach Rupp and all that he stood for. Excellence in athletics, in life, and in everything you do.
And we remind the players who get it that they're given a horrible responsibility, a big responsibility, because on their shoulders now rest to try to match his accomplishments in life.
And much of those accomplishments included helping others, a generous side Rupp chose to hide. Still, it shines in the spirit of those he left behind.
Even at, you know, at Rupp Arena back in Lexington, do you ever just sit there and go, wow, this is us, this is my family?
Yes, no question about it, the whole family. Our daughters danced on the floor, our sons played on the floor. I've walked around the floor and been interviewed, and it's always a thrill every time.
And his legacy will continue to light up the sports world at every Final Four through his prestigious award. And the Rupp Award was awarded this morning at 11 o'clock. The AP Player of the Year, Antoine Jamison from North Carolina, and the AP Coach of the Year, Tom Izzo from Michigan State. Congratulations, and Robyn, you've got a wacky crew over here.
Check this out. Didn't this remind you of the Today Show, how everybody says outside? You guys make great signs. Let's see them. Yeah. Wonderful. Well, tell me who you are and where you're from.
I'm Sally Lewis. I'm here from San Antonio, but really a Kentucky native at heart.
Well, we love your signs. Do you have tickets yet?
Thank you. We don't have tickets.
No tickets!
Oh, I'm sorry. Unfortunately, my uncle, who is in Lexington, was supposed to get us some tickets, and it fell through at the last minute. I'm so sorry. Keep looking. Keep looking.
That's right.
Well, I want to talk to you two because you got one of these neat Final Four balls. And what is this? Sports Illustrated, what you got there?
It's Nazi Muhammad.
Now, did he really sign that, or did you fake it?
He tried to fake it. tried to get an offer.
Well, I'm sure you guys, if you can't be at the game, you're going to be watching tomorrow, right?
Yeah, on a big screen.
What do you think UK needs to do to win tomorrow night?
They need to play good defense, I think. And they need to guard Antoine Jamison.
All right, well, we will pass that along to Coach Smith, okay? Thanks so much, you guys. We are here with the Trojans in San Antonio. We'll be right back.
I tell you what, Fayette Mall is rocking.
That's right. We've got several thousand True Blue fans here. The Henry Clay High School Prep Band. We're cheering on the Big Blue all across the country. We'll be back with more right after this.
Toyota dealer in a spring sales event.
And this is big. The Toyota factory just announced a reduction on Camry leases to $219 a month. $219 a month for an equipped Camry.
Camry's the best-selling car in America, and I've always wanted one.
Not just the best-selling, it's the best-built, too. And right now, your Toyota dealer's got them equipped and ready to go.
Now's the time.
But not for long. This Camry special ends March 31st.
See your Toyota dealer. He's there to help you get more for less.
Every day.
Johnny Bench for S&K's National Suit Sale.
S&K has more suits on sale than you can imagine. You like wool blend suits? Get two for just $200. Pure wool suits, two for $300. Designer and famous maker suits, two for $400. Two suits for less than you'd expect to pay for one at a department store, and thousands to choose from at S&K. Now, where are you going to buy your next suit?
Shop S&K in Regency Center on Nicholasville Road.
Finding a home that's just right for you, a home that meets your special needs, may be easier than you think. RE/MAX Associates across the continent lead the real estate industry in experience and average number of sales per agent. They know their market, and they care enough to get to know you. RE/MAX Associates have helped millions of families make their real estate dreams come true. Don't you think it's your turn? RE/MAX, the hometown experts with a world of experience.
We've got a lot of things from Best Buy. You should make our house a Best Buy house.
Ma'am, we're the Best Buy Residence Evaluation Team.
Come on in.
In order to declare your house an official Best Buy house, we're going to need to take a look around. Is that okay, ma'am? How would you classify the selection?
Large. I needed a scanner and a fax machine.
Surround sound?
Yes.
Congratulations. Here's your plaque.
Oh, thanks.
Here's your certificate. And if you'll initial right here for the optional yard sign.
The optional what? This is a yard sign.
The Best Buy house. Now that's a great idea.
It's so big.
Hi, we're back live at Fayette Mall with the world's largest pep rally. We've got several thousand, the truest and bluest fans here cheering on the Wildcats. Going to chat with a few of them. Tell me where you're from. What's your name?
Jalen Sexton, and I'm from Corbin.
You're from Corbin. What words have you got for the Wildcats this weekend?
Can't
What would you say to the Wildcats this weekend to cheer them on?
Go Wildcats!
There you go. Woo! Where are you from?
Georgetown, Kentucky.
And what's your name?
Tara Kelly.
Cheer on the Wildcats for me. What would you tell them this weekend to get them fired up?
Win.
You win now. I got to show you here this little cheerleader down here. What's your name, sweetheart?
Morgan.
Yeah, now notice you got a number 34 on one cheek and a 13 on the other. What are those numbers for?
For the Wildcats.
Yeah, do you know what people those numbers go with?
Kentucky.
That's right, absolutely, yeah. We have a feeling, by the way. Can I see your cheeks again here? This will be the score at the end of the first half, 34 to 13. I'll let you guess who's going to be in the lead at that point. What's your name, son?
Travis.
Travis, where are you from?
I'm from Lexington, Kentucky, Nicholasville.
Yeah, you cheer for the Cats this weekend?
Yeah.
Cool, all right. And one more here before we run off. Come on, tell me your name real quick.
Christy Smith.
Yeah, say go Big Blue.
Go Big Blue.
There you go, all right. Nancy, up to you.
I tell you what, Stuart, we've got some great True Blue fans here tonight. But today, there were scores of True Blue fans packed into Bluegrass Airport, ready to head down to Texas. And while it was a great day for flying, some of our True Blue fans had a little pre-flight turbulence. Here's Karen Acar.
You could call it True Blue madness, but Dwight McCarty wouldn't miss it. He's a Final Four veteran.
This makes third one in a row. This one's a little better because we have tickets and a place to stay at the Sleep Inn. I think it's a Comfort Inn diversion, yeah. I hope. It has beds. I already checked that out.
Some fans faced flight delays, while others took a last-second shot at standby seats.
Some True Blue fans who already had tickets to San Antonio showed up hours before their flight. It was part of their strategy for trying to score a better seat.
They were shooting for a spot on an earlier flight.
It's in case someone unfortunately doesn't show up or gets caught in traffic or something similar to that, they're willing to step in and take their spots.
But with a True Blue crowd like this, the odds are against any no-shows.
Hey, those fans are happy to be in Texas tonight, but we're happy to be here. We've got a little protection here, too.
Absolutely. You know? We have no fear. The True Blues brothers are in the house tonight.
Can't you smile just a little bit?
No.
Okay. We've got our smallest True Blues brother here. It's hard to smile the whole time, isn't it? She's doing a good job of it. Hey, let's go back to Texas.
All right. Thanks a lot, Nancy. I'm so glad they're having fun back at home, too.
It sounds like they've got a great crowd out there at the mall, and it really makes me feel good because we've got a great crowd down out here in Slam Antonio, the new name. In honor of Nazi Muhammad, it's Slam Antonio.
What do you guys think of that? Yeah! I want to bring a gentleman in here who went to UK, graduated the year that they won the championship in 78.
Correct.
All right, 20 years later, what do you think?
It's awesome. I come back every time I get a chance. I went to the first game in Rupp Arena. And it was really nice to see they brought the big blue chair out when the coach Rupp was there. And it was real sad the day that he died that they never brought it back again. And there's no better fans out there than Kentucky fans.
All right, thanks so much. Thanks all of you. And we will be back with much more Showdown in San Antone after this.
Hey, Josh, Nicole, Miranda, Dylan. Josh, we can't bring you home Jeff Shepard, but we'll try to bring you home a victory, okay?
100% approved.
100% approved.
Because at Jerry Delaney's North Broadway Auto Sales, we don't run a credit check. Bankruptcy, bad credit, no problem.
Because there's no credit check.
You can choose from any car on the lot, and we don't need a credit check because you're approved.
Approved.
No matter what you're looking for, North Broadway Auto Sales is here for you.
Because there's no credit check.
So stroll on down to North Broadway Auto Sales and tell them you're approved.
Approved.
For your new car today. And there's no credit check.
When you wake up, is life just a blur? Are you always dealing with your glasses or contact lenses? Are you tired of the hassle of being nearsighted? Maybe we can help. Now, thanks to the eczema laser, a scientific revolution in eye surgery, you may be able to eliminate the aggravation of glasses or contact lenses. For more information on the eczema laser, please call the Eye Institute of Central Kentucky at 1-800-ABOUT-RK.
It was an old family car their father would pile them into when they were little. Their father was a dentist, and on Fridays and Saturdays, he would drive out to provide free dental care for many children of families who needed it. In the years since, Charlie Owens known what it means to fight crime as a federal prosecutor, what it takes to overhaul Kentucky's criminal laws as director of the State Crime Commission. He's rolled up his sleeves, started a business from scratch, met payrolls, created hundreds of jobs, and built a dream into a remarkable Kentucky success story. Now Charlie Owen can put that discipline, commitment, and real-world experience to work. A senator who won't owe the special interests anything, who has clear stands and new ideas from strong Kentucky values. Perhaps because Charlie Owen has never forgotten the lessons and values he learned from his father, traveling the state in the front seat of that old family car.
We are live in San Antone, where there's going to be a big showdown tomorrow in the Final Four. Final Four Eve, there is such energy in this city. It is just incredible. Hi, everybody. I'm Robyn Rabbeth, along with Alan Cutler and Suzanne Farmer. Alan, first of all, everybody wants to know, how are the Cats doing mentally?
I think they're about as ready can be. I think they're prepared. I think they're well coached. I think these kids know what they're supposed to do. They have a job to do. No matter what happens tomorrow, at least we all can rest tonight knowing that things are cool as far as having that right tune-up for tip-off.
Yeah, but what do you think is going to happen tomorrow?
Oh, I think we'll win. I can't imagine not winning. I have this fear that Stanford will throw so many elbows that these kids are going to be sore when they play North Carolina on Monday.
All right. Well, a lot of True Blue fans celebrating back at home, too, and we want to check in with them right now. Nancy Cox at Fayette Mall.
Hey, Robyn. Like we said, just thousands of True Blue fans here having a great time in Fayette Mall.
We've got a terrific crowd here. Want to show you the faces of the cheerleaders from Henry Clay High School.
Helping us out here.
Champions this year. Also the Woodford County Middle School cheerleaders over here. We're all cheering on the cast tonight and the Paul Lawrence Dunbar cheerleaders on this side. They're helping us bring out the cools for the True Blue Cats.
Is this not the biggest prep rally you've ever been to?
Yes, I love it, love it, love it, love it, love it, love it.
So do you think we can pull it off tomorrow?
Oh, sure we can.
No problem.
Where are you from? Clarksburg.
Did you drive up to this pep rally?
Yes, indeed.
Well, we are just tickled that you are here, and we're so glad all the True Blue fans are having such a party, even though they can't go to Texas.
It's absolutely, it's terrific to know that the Wildcats have this kind of fan support in San Antonio, in Lexington, and at this moment, probably many, many miles in between with all the fans headed that direction.
But Robyn, I bet you guys can hear us from there, can't you?
Oh, absolutely. You guys are just doing great. We can almost hear you all the way from Texas to Kentucky, and that is not an easy thing to do. Suzanne, you know what I've really enjoyed is just getting to see people that you don't see except in the postseason.
Right, exactly.
Because they always get together for these tournaments.
You know, no Kentucky fans, we know no strangers, definitely not. And I met a guy today. If you like Seinfeld and you shop at the J. Peterman store, you're going to love this story. J. Peterman has a son that lives right here in San Antonio, and I talked to him today about his True Blue roots. Tim Peterman remembers his days at UK like they were yesterday.
It was a religion. I mean, I was there back when Rex Chapman was the man. You know, when first year Rex came on campus, he had a little Rex necklace, sis, and by the time he went to the pros 2 years later, his Rex necklace was about this big.
Tim graduated from UK in 1989. Now he's the regional business manager at a Fox and Warner Brothers station in San Antonio. Tim says his coworkers have no doubt how true blue he is.
I'll slip the wins into everybody's, you know, inboxes and let them know that Kentucky continues to win.
Who's the bigger true blue fan, you or your father?
We'll put it this way. 4 minutes after the Duke win, so they were on the phone and we were talking about them coming down again, and you know, we were trying to work out the logistics, and he had to go out to Los Angeles that week, so it was, we had 2 days of back and forth for him to try to get down here and what we could get the tickets for and how much they were, and so I'd say we're about equal. I'd say he's more because he's in it every day. I'm a quiet but confident fan. I think we'll take North Carolina by six in the final. You'll be here through Tuesday.
Poor Peterman. He's like so many fans. He doesn't have a ticket, and he says he's praying for a ticket. Good luck to you. Nice job, Susie. Young man, where are you from?
Northern Kentucky.
And you have a little banner here. You came all the way, right?
Yeah.
What would it mean to you if the Cats win a national championship?
It'd be great.
It'd be great?
It'd be a dream.
One of the highlights of your life?
Yes.
Will they beat North Carolina Monday?
Yes, they will.
Are you worried about tomorrow?
No, I'm not.
Are you guys worried about tomorrow?
No!
Time to take a break. When we come back, a lot more from San Antonio as the Cats are one step away from the national championship game.
Hey, we've got one of our 18 Action News reporters here, Bethlyn Wagner. She just happened to be in St. Petersburg last weekend. And she happens to be a Henry Clay grad.
That's right.
Bethlyn, what was it like to be down there in St. Pete when the Cats made that unbelievable comeback and beat Duke?
You know, it's almost too good for words. The fans, the True Blue fans were going crazy. The media, we were going crazy. We didn't know whether we should cheer or start asking questions.
Did anybody go to sleep that night?
Nobody slept that night. It was so much fun.
Very nice, very nice. Hey, we're having a great time here.
Out tonight. We appreciate your cheering on the True Blue fans. It is astonishing if you stopped for a second to look around how many people are here tonight.
Unbelievable. Any Kentucky fans here? That was pretty lame. Let's try that. Blue fans here.
All right.
That's better.
We're going to divide them up. He's now blue. This side is now white. We're going to try this.
I'm going to be blue. Hey, we'll be right back with more excitement from Fayette Mall and the biggest pep rally you've ever seen. We'll be right back.
Melanie Hansen on carpet and why she cleans it with Stanley Steamer.
Between the things we do at home and the play groups and school, I need a carpet cleaner that knows our time is just as valuable as theirs.
Some carpet cleaners have you wait all day, but Stanley Steamer schedules arrival times at your convenience. Call them today, they'll clean today. That's same day service.
Stanley Steamer makes you feel right at home.
Call today for this great special, only from Stanley Steamer.
The cars are powered by gasoline. The drivers are powered by their dreams. The pit crews powered by adrenaline. And the fans are powered by it all. So what's electricity have to do with NASCAR racing? Well, without it, Kentucky's Energy Cooperatives, a Touchstone Energy partner, the power of human connections.
There's a shape that's so soft, like an ocean wave, come tumbling down so gently.
I like the color of, I like the color of, there is no other of.
Me!
Oh no, look!
It's a termite stampede!
Fear not, my wood friends, there's a new sheriff in town.
The Orkin Man!
Yeah, it's Roundup time!
You got them all!
Knock on wood.
No need, Chief. You've got this.
Oh, I can guarantee.
Yep, total satisfaction or your money back.
Got termites. Call Orkin for a free inspection and guaranteed protection.
Let's move them out.
Hit it.
Papa John's must really be hurting Pizza Hut. They actually sent out this Sock It to Papa John's toy to boost
it's
morale.
Up to you to stop with the Papa. We're not afraid of these Papa John's guys. Heck no. Steve, show Kelly how to do it.
But we doubt it will win them back a single customer.
Oh, boy, what a shot.
Using the best ingredients we can find. That's how we win your loyalty. So let them keep slapping me around. I'll just keep making you better pizza.
Now, get a large one-topping Papa John's pizza for just $8.99.
I want to say hello to my nieces, Ashley and Allison, my sister, Mary Case, and my brother-in-law, Bill. Bill, thanks a lot for not coming through with those tickets you promised me. I love you, man.
You are looking at the True Blue fans who have made their way all the way to South Central Texas for the Final Four. And you know what? Usually on the map, San Antonio is in South Central Texas, but I think this weekend, It's the center of the universe. What do you think, Suzanne?
It is. Lots of Kentucky fans. And what I like about the Kentucky fans, you know, they are a little superstitious. So lots of the fans have out our old buttons, you know, the ones we brought out in 96, because we won the national championship in 96. So they're wearing both, the new ones and the old ones, to bring good luck.
I like it. I think it's going to work. Well, you know, even though you're seeing a lot of Kentucky fans here along the San Antonio River, we can tell you that the river might as well be flowing blue and white, because Texas is blue and white. Let's see what the True Blue fans in Lexington are up to. Hi, Nancy.
Hey, Robyn. We've got a lot of blue and white in Lexington as well. Can you believe this? We've got Perky the Peacock here with us. What a guy.
Yeah, we are at the world's largest pep rally here in the middle of Fayette Mall. True Blue fans all over the place coming to you live. We'll be here until 9 o'clock this evening as part of the showdown in San Antonio.
Having a great time. You know, Perky is the only guy we let sport any of these other colors. Because let me tell you what, Lexington was proud to show its true colors today.
Blue!
White!
Blue!
White!
Blue!
This is Blue White Day.
County Attorney's Office.
I did the stenciling for the paws that you see.
Put you in a UK mood.
Kind of unites the office together behind a team.
We love those Wildcats.
I have my Final Four hat on, and I have my True Blue Fan button. And my basketball pin, and my Wildcat face, and my other face.
The mayor declared it Blue and White Day, so we all wore our UK t-shirts.
Camaraderie for everybody. Everybody's getting along, everybody's saying hi, like your shirt, like your button.
We're great fans.
It's much more comfortable than wearing dress clothes. Sense of community pride, big blue, kind of togetherness.
We enjoy it. We have a good time. It's just like you're traveling with family, and it makes you feel like you're a part. And
hopefully that this will reflect on the game.
Blue! White!
This is the next best thing. If you can't be there.
Blue! White!
Back live at Fayette Mall. The best True Blue fans in the world right here with us. Tell me what your name is.
Ashley.
Ashley, what's your little sign say here? What's your sign say down in front of you here?
Go Cats!
Absolutely. Who have you got there, Nancy?
Hey, what's your name?
Amy Morgan.
Where are you from, Amy?
Versailles, Kentucky.
Versailles, Kentucky. Wonderful. Got a great sign here. I tell you what, this is the next best thing to being in San Antone.
Absolutely. We are thrilled, and we're going back to Texas.
Here we are back live in San Antonio, and Robyn, I think this is almost as good as having Christmas, because you've got all the fans. This is what True Blue Madness is all about, and the fans were all excited today at open practice, and very pumped up, very calm, but also very hysterical at the same time.
That's right. We met so many neat people today. People come from all over the place because it was their chance to see the Cats in action for free. You could just walk into the Alamo Dome, and you know, a lot of people having trouble getting tickets, and people are driving 17, 20 hours to get here. They don't have tickets, you guys.
Yeah, just to see practice.
Yeah, unbelievable. And I just met an absolutely wonderful family today at open practice. The cavernous dome, the gigantic banners, and the larger-than-life players can be overwhelming. But scenes like this one keep the Final Four firmly planted on the hardwood.
Yeah, those guys still play, don't they?
Yeah.
Who's Nazi?
Nazi Muhammad.
Joe Perez grew up in Kentucky and fell in love with the Wildcats. Now he lives in Texas, but he's teaching his sons to follow the True Blue tradition.
I remember one of my first memories of listening to Kentucky on the radio when Dan Issel fouled out of one of the, I think the Sweet 16 in the tournament, like in the 70s, and I was probably 11, 12 years old.
You've been a UK fan ever since?
Oh, well, yeah.
So the next time you think this Final Four frenzy is getting a little bit out of hand, remember, it's the little things that really matter.
I think he gets it more by osmosis by watching me and how I hoot and holler when I watch a game, or how serious I get when I watch the tube. But he has rooted them on, and he's got a couple of favorite players that he likes.
I like Wayne Turner because he does all that that neat stuff. I like when he does that neat stuff.
We here on the Riverwalk in San Antonio, where a lot of UK fans are gathering tonight on this eve of the Final Four. A very big night. I don't think very many True Blue fans are going to be sleeping well tonight. We're all very nervous.
Very hard to sleep. This is one man I met today in open practice. You were quite the happy fan, holding up your number one little finger and all that stuff. Tell me your name.
Chris Newsom.
Chris, you live here in San Antonio, don't you?
Yes, ma'am.
How difficult is it being a True Blue fan here in San Antonio?
Tonight it's pretty good.
Tonight it's good?
Yes, ma'am.
And everything is blue and white. You like that?
It is. I'm having a great time.
Have you got tickets?
No, not yet.
Not yet. He's going to be optimistic. And we've got more live fun coming from San Antonio. Stay with us.
How do Long John's new fish and chips stack up in London, the birthplace of fish and chips?
It's really interesting. What's that? It's fish. Oh, that's nice.
Wicked crispy.
Brilliant taste.
White and flaky.
Long John's new fish and chips, just $1.99.
That's a jolly good price.
And new waffle fries.
So where they from?
America.
America?
America?
All right, Cap, come on, get out.
London loves us so much, it hurts.
Please go.
If you've been injured in an accident, you'll face many difficult decisions. One of the important decisions will be selecting a lawyer to help you. Before deciding, ask the attorney to show you their trial experience, their national ratings, and national board certifications. I'm Gary C. Johnson. I've worked more than 24 years building a reputation helping injured people. I invite you to compare, because the lawyer you choose makes a difference.
Call Gary C. Johnson for a free consultation.
Today at the Kentucky Lottery's Powerball Development Lab, a ball of extraordinary proportions has escaped.
We were increasing the minimum jackpot to $10 million and adding a cash option when it overpowered us and broke through the wall.
The rogue ball has left a trail across the state. Dr. Newby has this advice for anyone encountering the ball.
Play it.
New ball, $10 million minimum jackpot, and a new option to take cash. Somebody's going to win. Might as well be you.
I'm a server at a restaurant, and it's really rough on the feet. The Gold Bond foot powder really makes your feet feel good.
Gold Bond medicated foot powder. Only Gold Bond absorbs moisture, controls odor with baking soda, and stops foot itch.
I highly recommend it.
Gold Bond foot powder. 3 foot relievers in one.
Hey, I know about tough pain. Boss calls and says, you gotta come in. I said, hey, my back's killing me. He says, try Flexol. Flexol is clinically proven to relieve tough pain.
And I say, so I get overtime.
You have a pain in the butt.
Yeah, try Flexol. No pain's too tough for Flexol.
Because no one expected us to be here either. I mean, everyone's, I guess, on our bandwagon now because we're playing, like they say, we're playing better than anybody in the country. And, you know, there's all this hype about being picked to win now. But, you know, I don't think we're necessarily the favorite right now. I think North Carolina's got to be the favorite.
We're back in San Antonio. We're down on the Riverwalk. We've kind of changed positions just a little bit. But, you know, the True Blue fans just seem to keep following us, don't they, Alan?
Everywhere we go, True Blue, it's like the Pied Piper.
Well, what have you been finding out today? Because, you know, he's been in open practice. You've been to all the news conferences. So you've got the lowdown on how the team is preparing for the big game.
I think they're perfect. They've been in this situation so many times. They're professional about it. They know how to handle it. Stanford was almost quietly giddy when they walked off the court, as if their kids are going, you know, we're really cool, but wow, look at this stuff. It's really neat. Where the Kentucky kids are kind of like, Robyn, you know, we were here last year. We were here the year before. This is a lot of fun. We know what we're doing. So some people thought the Kentucky kids didn't have emotion. That's not true. The Stanford kids had more emotion because this is a first for them. So it's just wonderful.
Well, what do you have for us in this segment, Alan?
All right, we've talked to some experts, some people that have been following basketball. I would say with these three men, at least 85 to 90 years, that these are from the finest experts in America. And the question we had was, obviously, rocket scientist. We wanted to know who's going to win, Kentucky or Stanford.
Well, I just think Kentucky's playing at a different level right now, and no matter what Mike Montgomery conjures up for the Cardinal to throw at the Wildcats, I don't think he's got enough.
Kentucky is the hot team. I think that the Kentucky-Carolina final has a chance to be an epic game, certainly the highest scoring final since Duke, Kentucky in 78, and maybe even pressing 100 points because Kentucky will keep the pressure on and force whoever they play to match their tempo or else they will die.
Can Stanford beat Kentucky?
Never in your wildest dreams, Alan.
Just that simple.
I think Kentucky will just overwhelm them with numbers. I think they'll overwhelm them with quickness. I love the matchup at the point guard spot, and if Pageant takes Mattson out about 13 feet and Kentucky rebounds the way they're capable of and gets a standoff in the paint, they're going to roll.
We're with Larry Vaught, the Danville Advocate Messenger sports editor. Now, Larry has been joining us on these sports specials for a long, long time. Before the season began, Larry, yourself, myself, and Sean Woods all had the same opinion that Wayne Turner was the key in this team, and you think that's true even today.
I sure do. It was a scary thought when we all agreed on anything. But if you look at this team, over the last 16 NCAA tournament games, Kentucky point guards, 91 assists, 16 turnovers. That's pretty strong, and if Turner keeps playing that way, Kentucky's going to win it all.
All right, Turner's the MVP of this tournament. Kentucky wins it all. You can see that evolving. We did a story at the beginning of the year, and Wayne Turner, as you know, we talked about this, he doesn't want to stay around next year. So if he's the MVP, can you see him going to the NBA?
Unfortunately, I think you can, because you're already hearing some players maybe drop a few hints about that. If he's MVP of this tournament, what else can he do next year? He couldn't do anything to make his stock rise any higher than what it would be right now.
And on January 1st, Wayne Turner wasn't one of the top 50 NBA prospects in America. It's amazing.
Right now, he'd probably be one of the top 10 very easily going into this tournament.
Rebounding is a big key playing Stanford.
It sure is, and I think Jamal McGlure will be a key for Kentucky, but maybe the real X factor will be Hishimu Evans because of the way he can come in and play physical.
Well, being the X factor, who can guard him? I mean, you look at it this way.
Not me or you.
Hishimu Evans and Allen Edwards is so much quicker than the slower, small forwards of Stanford. That quickness could be a tremendous advantage for the University of Kentucky.
Yeah, it should be. And then also, I still like Kentucky's chances at the guards. I mean, I think Turner and Shepard playing better than any guard tandem in the country right now, and that's going to bring them through.
And would you also say that Turner and Shepard are better than Kentucky's guards last year?
Right now, I would say yes.
So you like Kentucky to go all the way?
I like Kentucky. They're here, let's go all the way.
That's what it's all about.
That's exactly. You got to hope they win.
And you don't think they'll feel the pressure?
Not at all.
Me neither. This is pretty scary. Larry Vaught does a great job with the Danville Advocate. Messenger has been joining us. Thank you, Larry. A lot more coming up from San Antonio. When we come back, the Cats are one more way from going all the way.
These days, people are putting so many things on burgers, they hardly seem like burgers anymore. At Hardee's, we think it's time to go back to those classic ingredients that make a burger taste great. The kind of things you'll find on Hardee's new classic bacon double cheeseburger. Two big juicy patties, melted cheese, 8 strips of crispy bacon, lettuce, tomato, and special sauce. The new classic bacon double cheeseburger, only at Hardee's.
What do all these people have in common? They're all getting discounts on their auto insurance from Allstate. So, who's your insurance agent?
For all your insurance needs, call Bob Bailey, your Lexington Allstate agent, at 266-0654, across from Walmart next to Kroger on Richmond Road.
Being in good hands is the only place to be.
Have it all with this luxurious three-piece super sectional, just $1,498.
Value City Furniture. You just can't do any better.
There's strength and durability. There's Ford F-Series. There's power, convenience, and comfort. There's Ford F-Series. There's a $189 lease available on Ford F-Series. Just $189 a month for 24 months, only at your local Ford dealer.
There's fun and versatility. There's Ford Ranger. There's two- and four-wheel drive. There's Ford Ranger. There's a $149 lease or low 1.9 financing available on Ranger. There's only one place to get it, your local Ford dealer.
Say hi to my in-laws, the Johnsons. I'm here in San Antonio enjoying myself, and go Wildcats, go Wildcats.
We are back in San Antonio with all the true blue fans having a great time. And Alan, you are on the beat, you know what's going on. Tell us what makes this tournament so special. You've been to a lot of them.
The unpredictability. We never know who's going to make the last second shot. You never know when a Valparaiso is going to do it. That's what makes this event beautiful. As a matter of fact, since 1979, since they started this format, only twice have they had the two number one seeds play for the national championship. In 1998, for example, there have been 17 upsets so far. Well, Kentucky fans have their fingers crossed, and they're hoping that Stanford will not be number 18.
There will be no problem asking, where's the beef? Stanford's star is Mark Mattson, 6'8", 235, strong as an ox. Plus, he can pop a shot from the outside, a classic power forward.
You know, I do think that we're a physical team. And that is part of our starting lineup, and it's really part of all of our guys off the bench as well.
The key is stopping Mattson. I hope coach gives me an opportunity to play him. I feel that I could do well on him. But again, I realize they're very physical players, and I'm looking forward to tomorrow's game.
And the mountain of a man, 7'1", 260-pound Tim Young. Stanford not only has literally bloodied and bruised the enemies on the way to the Final Four, but they're also out-rebounding the opposition by a whopping 12 a game.
We got to kill teams on the boards to win games, and if we can get better opportunities, on the glass, we have a lot better chance to score.
Definitely, we need to control the boards, but we also need to keep the game at a pace that we want to play at, not what they want to play at.
If there is one phase of the game that Tubby prides this team on more than any other, it's rebounding. Not just because the Cats were number one in the Southeastern Conference, but because rebounding to Tubby is pure heart and hustle.
We're going to definitely have to crash the boards. We've been practicing, rebounding all last 2 days, and it's been physical.
The big key with those guys being so strong is we need to keep the ball out of the post as much as possible and try to nab the ball because they're so big. They can cause problems down low if we let them keep getting a lot of catches in the lane.
We're going to take the rest of tonight, tomorrow, and continue to get ready for them, especially for the way the kind of physical game they play. I think that's probably going to be the one thing that we're going to have to overcome more than anything else is just how physical they are in the way they post up and the way they box out and the way they basically just play the game.
One man that knows all about strategy for Stanford is Rhode Island's coach. Tim Gordon and Veronica Duca talked with Jim Herrick about the game plan.
They both match up really well with each other. They're both big. They both have good size. They both have good three-point shooting. Stanford has some quickness at the guard. So does Kentucky. They've both got depth off the bench. It's going to be a very, very close game.
Where is our strength then if we're to beat them? Is it up front, inside?
I don't think you've got too much of an advantage inside because of Mark Mattson. He's just they call him Mad Dog, and he's the strongest guy I've ever played against or ever known in college basketball. And we know them very well and played them very well in the Elite Eight game, but then they came back and had a miracle and beat us.
Do you think it's going to take a miracle for Kentucky to beat Stanford?
No, I don't think so because Stanford's weakness, I think, is when Arthur Lee doesn't have the ball. And if they can keep the ball out of his hands, the more they keep it out of his hands, the better off they'll be.
Do you think Kentucky's going to prevail against Stanford or beyond?
If I had to pick, I would pick Kentucky, North Carolina. And then I have a real strong feeling. I think Kentucky can win it all. I really do.
Well, we're here with all the True Blue fans who made their way to San Antonio. Somehow, some way, it is worth it. This gentleman made a super sign. Who are you?
I'm Jim Perrito. I'm a native Lexingtonian, but I live here now in Canyon Lake.
What is it like having UK here?
Oh, this is a dream. When they announced 3 years ago it was going to be here, I had hopes that they'd be here. Now I'm a Cat fan in Cat heaven,
Oh, well, it's so good to see all of you all. Now let's go back to Lexington and see what's going on there.
We're having a great time. Absolutely outstanding time here at the fans here. It is so cool to link up the fans in Texas with the fans in the Bluegrass by satellite. It's something else.
It is wonderful, and all that spirit and all that fan support is going to carry this team to another national title. Stuart, there are some guys behind me from Stanford, Kentucky. You guys are True Blue fans from Stanford.
Yes, we're True Blue fans from Stanford, Kentucky.
Gotta get that Kentucky in. What's it been like being in Stanford this week? I mean,
wild. We've had a big pep rally this afternoon, and there was about 1,500 to 2,000 people there.
All true blue fans.
Stanford, Kentucky.
Well, thank you, folks from Stanford, and from we've got folks from Lawrenceburg, Campbellsville. They're from all over here.
Absolutely. True blue fans all across Kentucky and today all across the nation.
So, Robyn, everybody in Kentucky, they're sending their support on your way. So help us bring it home.
And you know what? Everybody else here has that same exact thought. Just help us bring it home. Well, this is what it's like in San Antonio tonight. Lots of true blue fans hanging out. A lot of people have sunburns, too, because it's been in the 80s. Yeah.
Us, we're the only white ones left, I think. We've got so many red faces.
Well, that's because we're working real hard. But you know what? We are having a great time. We're just so glad that we could bring it all to you, because this is what it's all about. Of course, a big game tomorrow, and we'll see you tomorrow on 18 Action News at 6, too. Well, we're going to leave you now from San Antonio and all the True Blue fans. Let's hear it.
Go, Big Blue!
Thanks a lot for joining us.
Show.